Okay, so I'm talking to a client and you're sitting there and you're listening, you're starting to see all this stuff and you're filtering and looking and all that. So I get them more specific. We determine, are we talking about a walk-in? Are we talking about an entity? Is it a group of entities? Is it the secret space program? Let's say they feel like they have a secret space program issue. Maybe that's why they came to us. So we tighten that up and then I get them talking about that and why they think it might be possible. And so now, is that tight enough usually for you to start seeing if there's secret space program stuff there, or do you like it a little even tighter than that?
Most of the time it's tight enough, but it's usually not just one instance. People who are involved with secret space program or any kind of abductions, twain bats, it's never just like, oh, it happened for 1 hour this long and there's this one event. It's like, yeah, you've been taken every single night, and sometimes, well, every single night, like that's too generalized. People get taken 15, 20 times a year, at least, not everyone, but really depends with our clients. It's like always a thing. But then we would go with, okay, we look at the issue, how much do they want to know, how impactful it is. Because like some events or things that we look at as regards secret space program will be just pure torture. Just imagine for 20 hours laying on a table, being cut up, open, and operated on, and feeling the pain, or being raped, or something else like that. Yeah, like how much should I tell the person? Is it like, is it important to them? Will it help them in this session? Is it something they need to hear? Will this relieve their pain? No. Well, then let's focus on something specific that they need to hear right now. Oh, yeah, you've been having issues with communication. Let's go specifically into what caused issues with communication. So, like, there's tons of instances with what happens in those like secret space program experiences and all. And I try to be honest and just give all the information, but recently I started to pick out because like I see a lot of people who are clear of beliefs and stories that are impacting their life and limiting them. And I don't want to throw in anything that will ruin it for them. I want them to keep creating and getting better. So if there is information I find or things I see that can help them with that, like where they get more understanding and understand why it's happening to them, why do they feel that way? Yeah, good. But if it's just a thing of pure torture all for the whole experience while they're out there, why would he need to know that? Like that depends. Like yeah, it's tight enough usually, but sometimes like focusing on specifics for their current issue, not just generalized. Oh, I've been at 20 and back. What happened to me? Or oh, I want to know what happened in my past life. Okay, which one? Because you've been killed, you've been raped, and then you've been doing it. Do you need to know what you did to others? Do you need to know how you messed up others? People are not ready to confront that stuff yet, so
I get you.